Good morning, children. Today we are going to discuss about the volume of a cylinder. Volume of a cylinder. How it is forming? You know, carons, all of you. That is caron coils. If you put the caron coils one on another, one above the other, then we will get like this. This total shape is formed in the form of a cylinder. So if you put like this, you will get the shape of this. This is the cylinder. How can you find the volume of the cylinder? Means the area of base. What is the shape of area, shape of the base? It is in the shape of a circle. What is the area of circle? Is right, very good, pi r square. And it becomes one another means it becomes as the height. Therefore volume of cylinder equal to area of base, that is pi r square, into height h. That is the volume of a cylinder. Now if we observe that example one is there given, a rectangular paper of width 14 cm is rolled along its width and a cylinder of radius 20 cm is formed. Find the volume of the cylinder. What is given there? It is a rectangular paper. Paper length, length is 14 cm. This is the length 14 cm. It is a paper, rectangular paper. Its length is 14 cm. It is folded along its width. So if it is folded like this, then what is happening? The length of the rectangular paper is becomes as the height of the cylinder. Therefore we can conclude that height of a cylinder equal to 14 cm. Therefore length of the rectangular paper is become as the height of a cylinder. Therefore directly I am writing as the height of a cylinder equal to 14 cm. H equal to 14 cm, and it is folded along its width, and it is in the shape of a circle, and its radius is given. What is the radius? It is 20 cm. Radius of cylinder R equal to 20 cm. What we have to find? Find the volume of the cylinder. So volume of the cylinder, we know what is that? Volume of cylinder, volume of cylinder V equal to, just now we discussed, that is very good, pi r square h. Substitute in this pi, you know already, 22 by 7 into r square. What is r? 20. 20 square means it is multiplied by 20 into 20 into h. What is h? 14. Now is there any cancellation? Right, 7 ones, 7 to 14, that equal to 22 into 2, 44, 44 into 20 into 20, that is 400. How much it is? 44 into 4, multiply with that, 44 into 4, 17,600 cubic centimeters. Cubic centimeters or centimeter cube. Cubic centimeters or centimeter cube. This is the required volume of the cylinder. Now come to the second problem. Second example. Once read the problem. A rectangular piece of paper 11 cm into 4 cm is folded without overlapping to make a cylinder of height 4 cm. Find the volume of the cylinder. Find the volume of the cylinder. So again it is given that rectangular paper measurements are given 11 and 4. So again I am taking the rectangular paper. It is the 11 centimeters length and 4 centimeters height. That is 11 centimeters length, 4 centimeters height. It is folded along its length. That is folding like this without overlapping the edges. Without overlapping the edges means if you fold in the shape of a cylinder, it will become like this. Here, if you observe that, what is happening? Length of a paper is becomes as the circumference of a cylinder. Length of a rectangle paper is becomes as the circumference of a cylinder. And width of a paper is becomes as the height of the cylinder. So we can conclude that the length of a rectangular paper, that is 11, becomes as the circumference of the cylinder. Width is becomes as the height of the cylinder. Therefore, directly I am writing, height of cylinder h equal to 4 centimeters, circumference of cylinder. What is the circumference of cylinder means? What is the base of the cylinder? It is in the shape of a circle. What is the circumference of the circle? 2 pi r. Therefore, we can write as 2 pi r equal to 11 centimeters. From this, can we find the radius r? Yes. 2 pi r equal to 11. Substituting this r, we have to find the r value. R equal to 11. It becomes as division, that is 2 pi. Substituting this, r equal to 11 by 2 into, what is pi value, you know, right? Very good. 22 by 7. It is division becomes as a multiplying. That is 11 ones, 11 twos. That equal to 7 by 4 centimeters. It is the radius, r equal to 7 by 4 centimeters. Height is h equal to 4 centimeters. Then what we have to find? We have to find volume of a cylinder. Therefore, volume of a cylinder, you know formula, V equal to pi r square h. Substituting this, 22 by 7 into r square, what is r? 7 by 4, that is 7 by 4 into 7 by 4 into h. What is h? H is again 4 centimeters. Now 7, 7 get cancelled, 4, 4 get cancelled, 2 2's, 2 11's, that is 11 into 7, 77 by 2, if you cut it, that is 38.5 cm³, that is the required volume of the given cylinder. Come to the example 3. A rectangular sheet of a paper 44 centimeters, 18 centimeters, 44 centimeters into 18 centimeters, rolled along the length to form a cylinder. Assuming that the cylinder is solid, find its total surface area and the radius. Find the total surface area and the radius. So, again, it is given the measurements of a rectangular paper sheet. What is given? 44 and 80. So again, it is a rectangular sheet. It is 44 length and it is 80. It is folded along its length. That is, it is a 44. So again, it is same. This length is becoming as the circumference of a cylinder. And the width is becomes as the breadth is becomes as the height of a cylinder. Again, directly I am writing as height of a cylinder h equal to 18 centimeters, h equal to 18 centimeters. Next, circumference of a cylinder. According to circumference, what is the formula? Same as the previous problem. 2 pi r equal to 44 centimeters. 44 centimeters. Then, can you find the r value from this? Right, 2 into 2 pi r equal to 44. Then r equal to 44 by 2 pi. That equal to 44 by 2 into, what is pi value? Right, 22 by 7. Pi 7 becomes as into 7, that is 11 twos, 11 fours, 2 ones, 2 twos, 2 cancel, what is remaining? 7. That is radius r equal to 7. Radius r equal to 7 centimeters. And next, what do you want to find? Total surface area. What do you want to find? Total surface area. Total surface area of cylinder. What is the total surface area of cylinder formula? Right, very good. 2 pi r into h plus r. Substitute this. What is 2 into pi? 22 by 7 into r. What is r? Just now we find that is that 7 into, what is that h? H equal to 18 plus r is 7. So 7, 7 get cancelled. 22 is 44. 44 into 18 plus 7. That is 25. That equal to 44 into 25. Multiply. What is it? 44 into 25 multiplication is equal to, that is 1100 centimeter square. This is the total surface area of the required cylinder. Next, come to the example 4. It is the fourth problem, example 4. Once read the problem. Circular disc 5 millimeters thickness are placed one above the other to form a cylinder of a curved surface area 462 centimeters square. Find the number of disc if the number of discs if the radius is 3.5 centimeters. So here it is given that we have to find the number of plates. What is the condition is given? We don't know the number of plates, but the thickness of each plate is 5 millimeters. Therefore, we can write that thickness of a plate equal to 5 millimeters. Thickness of a plate equal to 5 millimeters. And next, what is given? Radius of disc. Radius of disc equal to 3.5 centimeters. 3.5 centimeters. So here it is, if you observe that, here the measurements are 5 millimeters. Here it is 3.5 centimeters. Change the millimeters into centimeters or centimeters into millimeters. Now I am changing that millimeters into centimeters. What we should do? Right, it is divided by 10. 5 by 10 centimeters. That equal to 0.5 centimeters. It is the thickness of a plate equal to 0.5 centimeters. Radius of disc equal to 3.5 centimeters. So, and what is given there? Curved surface area of cylinder. Curved surface area of cylinder is given that 462 centimeters square. 462 centimeter square. According to what is the curved surface area of cylinder formula? That is 2 pi r h equal to 462 centimeter square. Here what we know that radius of the disc r equal to we know, and we have to know h. H means if we put the plates one on the other, it becomes as a h. That h, how can we get that h? H equal to, that is number of plates into the thickness of the plate. That is the h value we have to find like that. That is h is nothing but number of plates into thickness of the plates. What we have to find? Number of plates. Therefore, let the number of plates equal to x. Therefore, then height of the cylinder becomes as height of cylinder equal to number of plates into thickness of the plate. So thickness of plate is 0.5 centimeters into number of plates is x. This is the height of the cylinder h equal to. Now substitute these values in this, then we will get the number of plates equal to x. That we can find the value of x by substituting in this. That is 2 into 22 by 7 into what is r? Radius is 3.5 into h. What is h? 0.5 into x equal to 462. Here unknown value is x, that is the number of plates. We have to find that number of plates, that is x in separator x, x equal to 462 by what is here? 2 into 3.5 into 0.5. 22 by 7 is there. It becomes as 7 by 22. Let us simplify that. 7 ones, 7, 0.5. Next, 11 2 is 22, 11 4 is 44, and remaining 2, 11 2 is 22. Next, 2 1s, 2 21s. Opposite is 21 that equal to 21 by 0.5 into 0.5, 0.25, 0.25 into 2 that equal to 21 by 0.5. 0.5 we can write as 1 by 2. That is 21 by 1 by 2 becomes as 1 into 2. That equal to 21 2s 42. This is the number of plates. Therefore, total number of plates equal to 42. This is the required answer. Next, come to the example 5. I am not giving the time to note down because you can pause the video and you can note down. So that fifth example. A hollow cylinder having external radius 8 cm and height 10 cm has a total surface area of 338 pi centimeters square. Find the thickness of hollow metallic cylinder. Find the thickness of hollow metallic cylinder. So it is a hollow metallic cylinder. Means, for example, nowadays we are seeing our government is giving the water for all houses. In that they are using the pipes for the water flowing. It is given the pipes. You can observe the beside the roads. So pipe is how it is. Suppose it is a cylinder. The pipe is like this. It will be like this. But it has the this paper has no thickness. But our cylinder in a problem the cylinder has some thickness. That is, this thickness is there. When it has a thickness, inside, from here to here it is the internal radius, from outside to here it is the external radius, internal radius and external radius, and between that, between the difference of internal and external, that is nothing but the thickness of the our required cylinder. So thickness means what is here is forming, it is the form of a ring, it is the form of a ring, means you have to know that area of the ring also we should know. Already you know area of the ring from the previous classes. Now what is given? If you come to our problem, external radius, example 5, external radius of hollow cylinder, external radius of hollow cylinder, external, that's why I am identifying as capital R, that equal to 8 centimeters. Next, internal radius, we don't know actually, internal radius of hollow cylinder, it is denoted by small r equal to some x. Let internal radius of hollow cylinder r equal to x. Next, height of the cylinder is also given. Height of a hollow cylinder h equal to, what is given there? 10 centimeters. Is x centimeters? It is 10 centimeters. Total surface area of hollow cylinder, total surface area of hollow cylinder equal to 338.5 centimeters square. Here we have to observe that total surface area of hollow cylinder means, we have to observe that the cylinder is like this. Total surface area means external surface area, thickness is there now, that's why internal surface, internal surface area, and the thickness, thickness is there, that is nothing but area of a ring. These addition of these three is only the total surface area of our given hollow cylinder. That is, total surface area means here we have to add these three measurements: external surface area, internal surface area, and the area of the ring. Therefore, total surface area of hollow cylinder equal to total surface area of hollow cylinder equal to external surface area plus internal surface area plus area of ring. So actually what is given according to the problem, it is given that 338.5. So external surface area, what is the external surface area formula? That is, external surface area is 2 pi rh plus internal surface area is 2 pi small rh plus area of ring. You know already area of ring, that is the pi area of the ring, it is upside and downside, therefore it is 2 pi r square minus r square. You know from the previous class, area of the ring is pi r square minus r square, that is top and bottom, therefore 3 into pi into r square minus r square. See, let us see any common is there, so we can take out the common 2 pi, 2 pi common, what is mean there, r h plus 2 pi is common, small r h plus 2 pi is common, r square minus r square equal to 338.5. Any cancellation is there, right? 5 pi will get cancelled and the remaining is 338, so becomes as division by 2 equal to r h. Already what we know external radius r, and we know height of the external radius r and the height of the cylinder h. We have to find only the internal radius, that is r, we don't know. So what we know, substitute in this, In that, what is that capital R? That is 8 into, what is H? H equal to 10 plus, small r we don't know, let it be X, that is X into H. What is H? Again 10 plus R square, what is R? 8 square minus X square. So, we can cancel with the 2, 2 1's 2, 2 6 12, 2 9's 18. That is 169 equal to 8 tenths, 80 plus 10x plus 64 minus x square. 64 minus x square. Send all the terms left side. That is what is there? 169, 80 plus 64. Right, 144, right to send to left side, then becomes as plus 144 becomes as minus 144 and x cube, 10x, 10x becomes as, if you take in the left side, plus 10x becomes as minus 10x, and what is the remaining, minus x square is there, send the minus x square left side, then becomes as the plus x square, the remaining is 0. Now, right in order, that is x square term first. Next minus 10x and next 169 minus 144, that is right, 25 equal to 0. If you observe that it is in the form of a quadratic equation, or it is in the form of a square minus 2ab plus b square. What is b square here? 25. Then what is b? 5. Therefore, we can write as it is in the form of a square minus 2ab plus b square. We know very well what is this formula, a minus b whole square. According to this formula, we can write as x minus b square is 25, that is b is 5 whole square. X minus y whole square equal to 0, that is x minus 5 equal to 0, that is x equal to 5. What is x? What we considered x? The internal radius of a cylinder r equal to x, that is therefore internal radius r equal to 5 centimeters. Actually, what we have to find? We have to find the thickness of the hollow cylinder. Thickness means how can we get? External radius minus internal radius. Already we know external radius is given. Therefore, thickness of hollow cylinder equal to thickness of hollow cylinder equal to capital R minus small r, that equal to what is capital R? 8 minus 5, that equal to 3 centimeters. It is our required thickness of hollow cylinder. Next, then what is the radius? Then radius equal to Then you have to find the h. What about the h? How it is changing? Let the height equal to x. Because the condition is given, it should not be a change. Therefore, according to land surface area, what is the formula? 2 pi r h equal to, when the radius is doubled, r becomes as 2r, h becomes as x. Therefore, 2 pi into, what is r? It is doubled. 2r, what is h? We consider it is the x. Now, we have to find the value of x. That is, 2 pi r h equal to 2 into 2, 4 pi r x. So, we have to find the value of x. Send the remaining this side. Then, 2 pi r h by 4 pi r equal to x. So, pi r will cancel to 1s, 2 2s, that equal to h by 2. That is the value of x. Means, h becomes as half. When the radius is doubled, without changing the land surface area, the height becomes half of the height. Therefore, what we can do that? When the radius is doubled, without changing the land surface area, the height becomes half of the height. Therefore, height is becomes half. Height becomes as half. See there, in the primary second problem is there. A hot water system, that is a geyser, consists of cylindrical pipe of length 14 meters and the diameter is 5 centimeters. Find the total radiating surface of hot water system. The total, that is the geyser. We have to find the total surface area of the geyser. So, geyser is in the shape of a cylinder. Geyser is in the shape of a cylinder. What is given that? Length, that is the pipe length, that is the total length is 14 centimeters, that is the h equal to 14. Height is given. And the diameter is 5. Diameter, this total diameter is given, that is 5. So we have to find the total surface area of this geyser. Total surface area of geyser is nothing but the total surface area of a cylinder. So what is given there? Height of a geyser h equal to 14 meters. 14 meters. The diameter of a geyser d equal to 5 centimeters. Observe the measurements here. It is a 14 meters. Here it is a 5 centimeters. Diameter of D equal 5 centimeters, but we required only radius. Therefore, radius of a geyser R equal to 5 by 2 centimeters. So, height change into the centimeters or radius changes into the meters. So it is easy, you can change into the centimeters. That is 14, 1 meter equal to how many centimeters? Right, 100 centimeters. 14 meters means 14 into 100, that is 1400 centimeters. 1400 centimeters. What we have to find? Find the total radiating, total surface area of the geyser. That is total surface area of geyser equal to, we know the formula, what is the total surface area of cylinder? Right, 2 pi r into h plus r, that is the total surface area of the geyser Now substitute in that. What is given there? 2 into 22 by 7 into what is R? R equal to 5 by 2 into H. That is 1400 plus R 5 by 2. So is there any cancellation? 2 will get cancelled. 22 5 is 110. Keep as it is. 22 into 5 by 7 in bracket, what is that LCM? 2, 1400 into 2, that is 2800 plus 5, that equal to 2 ones, 2 elevens, 11 fives, 55 by 7 into 2805. Now 55 into 2805, that is if you multiply with that, what you will get? Equal to 14275 by 7. 1,54,275 by 7. You can cut it. 7 ones. 7 to 14. 7 to 14. 14 is completed. 0. 7 3 is 21. 65. 7 9 63. 0.2. Then point is becomes as 20, 7 2 is 14, and again 60, 7 8 is, so like that, it is, that is 2039.282, it is centimeter square, if you want to express in meter square, what we can do is, divided with 10,000, so that is 22,039.28 by 10,000 meter square. That is how many zeros are there? 4 zeros. Then the decimal becomes as here, that equal to 2.203928 meter square. This is a required total surface area of the geyser. Next, come to the exercise 10.2. Once read the first problem, if you observe the first problem, what is the problem seen here once? Once read. A closed cylinder tank of height 1.4 meters and the radius of the base is 56 centimeters is made up of a thickness of metal sheet. How much metal sheet is required? So what is given there? Cylindrical tank, its height is given 1.4 meters and the radius of the base is given 56 centimeters. How much metal sheet? It is closed. Closed means we have to find the total surface area of the closed cylinder. Means what we have to find? What is given there first of all? Height of a tank. Height of a tank. H equal to how much it is given? 1.4 meters. Radius of a tank. Radius of a tank R equal to 56 centimeters. It is given in meters, it is given in centimeters. So we can change meters into centimeters. Actually, it is given that the express in square meters. So change this in centimeters into meters. It becomes as, how can we change centimeters into meters?
Right. 56 divided by 100, that equal to, where is that? 0.56 meters. 0.56 meters. What we have to find? We have to find the how much metal sheet is required. It is closed cylinder, that's why. What is the total surface? What is we have to find? Total surface area of the cylinder. That is total surface area of tank equal to, what is the formula? Right. 2 pi r into h plus r. Substitute this 2 into 22 by 7 into what is r? R equal to 0.56 into h plus r. What is h? 1.4 plus 0.56. By simplifying here, 7 months, 7 into 7, 0.8, 56. And what is remaining? 22 into 2, 44. 44 into 0.8 into 1.4 plus 0.56. How much it is? You know addition. 1.4 plus 0.56. That is right. 1.96. 1.96. That is 44 into 0.8 into 1.96. If you multiply, you will get 68.992 centimeter square. 68.992 meter square, that is approximate, we can write as 69 meter square. This is the total surface area of the tank. So with this, we are stopping here our class, and tomorrow we will continue from the next problem onwards. Thank you.